The Pacific Northwest is now on the brink of another multi-day heat wave. As you're watching this, if you're in that area, you might be experiencing it too. In the worst case scenario that's been projected, temperatures could reach as high as 111 degrees Fahrenheit in some parts of Western Oregon by Friday before a weekend cool down. It might not get that bad, but it is still going to be very rough. So bad that these would actually be record-breaking numbers for the region if those records hadn't already been shattered a short time ago during the heat dome of not that many weeks before. And when you look at those numbers, when you see 111 degrees Fahrenheit, you might think, well, you know, I live in Arizona. There's been some heat. I live in California. It gets hot here too. But it's not necessarily the same thing. Tyler Kranz is a meteorologist who responded to these arguments, saying, we'll often hear people say, who cares if it's 106 or 108? It gets this hot in Arizona all the time. Well, people in Arizona have air conditioning. And here in the Pacific Northwest, a lot of people don't. You can't really compare us to the desert Southwest. Now, because there's so little ability on the individual level in people's homes to deal with heat of this magnitude, the governor, Kate Brown, has declared a state of emergency over the heat, activated an emergency operations center, citing the potential for disruptions to the power grid and transportation. City and county governments are opening cooling centers and misting stations in public buildings, extending public library hours, and waiving bus fare for those headed to cooling centers. So we're gonna go a little bit broad on this in just a little bit, but I wanted to give you a chance to get in, Ben. We don't know if the heat wave is gonna be as bad as the last one. It's looking like it might not be, but what are your thoughts about the current state of things?
Yeah, this is one of those areas of climate change that I think, when people think climate change, they think like deadly hurricanes, they think extreme like flooding and stuff like that. But the two most deadly things from climate change are air pollution and heat waves, where what they do is they take people who are already at risk, right? People with disabilities, people who are elderly, and children who are sensitive to things like heat and air quality, and puts them in a position where a lot of them end up dying because of extreme heat, because of poor air quality and things like that. And you get these mass populations of people who are suffering extreme health effects. And especially in the middle of a homelessness crisis here in the United States, it puts us in an even more difficult situation. And during a pandemic, I mean, how many hospital beds are open for people who, you know, are suffering from like a heat stroke or something? We're really just put at the brink right now. And ultimately, we don't have the systems of support in place that we really need. And there's not, to make matters worse, I bet air conditioners have probably gone up in price over the past 3 months in the Pacific Northwest.
Yeah. Yeah, and you know, we report on like these crises when they hit, but as with so many other topics, I have this sinking feeling that I mean, next year's not gonna be better. It's been going around like memes, like, you know, it's the hottest summer ever, enjoy it. It's the coolest summer for the rest of your life. Like, that's the sort of thing that we're really looking forward to here. And because we're on the brink of this heat wave, I wanted to go back to the last one, which we talked about quite a few times here on the Damage Report. It turns out that it is likely that more people died here in the United States than was expected. When you do an analysis of excess deaths in two different states, in Washington and Oregon, you can take a look here, the spikes that hit during the heat wave. Now, some of the past big spikes were caused by things like COVID, sort of understandably. But something like 600 more people than expected died in those two states during the heat wave. That is three times higher than the official state counts of heat related deaths. So officially on the record, a couple hundred people died. It's a massive tragedy, but it could actually be much worse than that. Now, we're hoping that this heat wave won't be as bad as that one, but this is really just the beginning. I mean, we're focusing on the Pacific Northwest because you don't expect the heat there, but as Ben is pointing out, this is everywhere. Arizona was massively hit by heat. In California, we had it too. It's really difficult to escape it. Any other thoughts, Ben?
Yeah, I think like the one thought, I'll take us a step further in terms of doomering, right? We're in the middle of a pandemic right now of coronavirus. But one of the things that changes when you have changing climate is changing patterns of things like mosquito populations, right? And they change where they are. And there's some pretty nasty bugs out there, like dengue fever, for example, that could very easily make their way to the United States and become endemic here as these patterns change with weather. so too these patterns of mosquito populations change. And that could lead to new pandemics of things that have been floating around in the global south for a while. And they might just find their way here in the United States and put us even further past the brink that we're already at.
Yeah. Yeah. And unfortunately, if we are hit by things like that, we've already demonstrated as a society that we're not willing to do what's necessary to protect ourselves. So that's exciting. Can't wait for the murder hornets to return. Yeah. So, look, I hope that the Pacific Northwest gets through this. It seems like the government is a little bit more prepared for it this time, but buckle up, because just like the wildfires in California, this is not a one-time thing that we just have to sort of, you know, give a stiff upper lip and get through. It is now the new normal.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.